Sairam students, I welcome all of you once again. As you know that in the last session, we had already completed lesson number 12, Food for All. So today, before beginning with the new lesson, let's revise once again whatever we have learnt in the Food for All, not completely, but little bit part we will revise once again because the particular concept of the Food for All, it is going to be useful in today's lesson also. So students, if you remember, in the Food for All, we had already learned there are certain seasons which exist in India, like Kharif season, Rabi season and Summer season. From these seasons, what we had learned? We had learned that there are particular crops which can be grown at only certain period of the year. They cannot be grown full year, okay? But we need wheat, rice, pulses, etc. throughout the year. This is the basic need of human being. Am I right? So students, in order to have the grain available throughout the year, one season's crops, it has to be stored and protected till the next year. Am I right? And we had already learned that there are certain techniques which we had learned in the last lecture, how to protect the crops. That we had learned, we spray insecticide and pesticide to protect the crops from insect and the pest. Even when the crops are harvested, when we store the crops in the sacks, in the warehouses also. So before keeping them, we mix certain chemicals in the grains. And even if you remember, we had mixed certain neem leaves also inside the grains to avoid the fungal infection. Am I right? So these grains we preserve. These all variety of the grains we preserve so that they can be available for us in the future also. So students, exactly in the same manner, whatever grains which are available at the home, we can't use them completely at once only. Sometime we cook the food material. Okay, if the food material prepared for one meal, if it is not finished, then what we do? Like I just told you, if the grains are produced in the maximum quantity, so those grains are dried well under the sun and they kept in the sacks and they stored in the house or warehouses for the preservation purpose so that can be used later on. Exactly in the same manner, when we cook food at home and suppose if any food remains extra, okay, if there is one meal is not completely finished, so do we throw the food material into the garbage which is not used? No, we don't throw the food inside the garbage. As you all know that we consider Anna hai Purna Brahma, that you all know, we consider food as the God. Okay, so we shouldn't throw the food inside the garbage. So what we do if the food is not finished? Any guesses? So we store the unfinished food inside the refrigerator. We keep extra food inside the refrigerator so that can be used by us whenever we require. Am I right? So what are all things we keep in the refrigerator? Of course, not all type of the food can be kept in the refrigerator. Milk we can keep in the refrigerator. It will remain fresh as it is. Vegetable and few fruits also we can keep in the refrigerator so that it will remain fresh as it is. Am I right? Suppose if any sabzi or dal, if it is extra, then also we can keep in the refrigerator. So what are we trying to do here? The unfinished meal we kept in the refrigerator so that we avoided that food from getting spoiled. If we could have kept that food outside, then that food might have got spoiled because of the microorganism. Am I right? And that spoiled food we can't consume as it is. And that's why student, the protection and the preservation of the cooked food is also important. In the last lesson, we learned that the storage and the protection of the grain is important. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about the cooked food. They also have to be preserved well. So, what are the different techniques which are used for the preservation of the food material? We are going to learn in today's lesson, lesson number 13, methods of preserving the food. So, in today's lesson, we are going to learn about one by one what are the different techniques of the food preservation which are commonly used by us. Okay? So, students, you know that whenever you visit market to buy the vegetable and to buy the fruits also, you must have seen that different foodstuffs are produced in the different places. Am I right? They have to be made available in good condition to the people at long distance. Like for example, orange, they are famous from the Nashik. So oranges from the Nashik, they has to be made available to the people all over the India. Am I right? Even you can see that certain mangoes, they are famous from the Ratnagiri or Kokan. So the mangoes from Ratnagiri and the Kokan, they are transported to all people in India in also good condition. So that means what, student? These foodstuff, they has to be transported in the good condition. So that means we have to be extra careful while transformation. So you must have seen that one more thing. Like for example, at daily basis, we buy eggs also and we buy milk also. Am I right? So it must be ensured that these eggs, milk and milk product remain in the good condition during the transport. Okay, from the dairy or poultry farm till they reach their users. Just imagine that if we buy milk packet and the date is expired, and expired milk product or expired any kind of the dairy product, if we consume, then what will happen? We shall suffer from the food poisoning. So that's why, students, always remember, before purchasing anything, might be it is chocolate, might be it is any kind of the milk or milk product, okay, or might be it is any kind of the cosmetic or shampoo, anything. Before buying anything, you have to be extra careful. You have to compulsory check the expiry date of the product. If the expiry date is finished and still you use that product, then we will suffer from the infection. Okay, so that's why the preservation of all this food, it has to be in the good condition. The protection and preservation is very important till they reach the users. Am I right? So here you can see that even different fruits and different vegetables, they are also available in the abundance in the different season. Even these fruits, they has to be transported very well till the users. So that's why they also have to be kept in the good conditions. Am I right? Have you observed many of the time apples, they are kept in, coated with the wax. And even sometimes you must have seen that the apples who the food vendor keeps for selling, no? Even that apple is also covered by one fibrous, fibrous wiry part. So why that is put outside the apple? Just because to give the extra protection. Are you getting my point over here? So even certain fruits like strawberry, etc., they are kept well in the boxes, so that it will be remain fresh and it will be in the good condition till they reach the user. So the sellers has to take extra care for preserving all type of the food material till the consumer buys it. Okay, so to prevent these large quantities of fruits and vegetables from getting spoiled and to enjoy them all year around, we make efforts to preserve them. So we have to make a lot of effort to preserve whatever food material which is required by us on the daily basis. Okay, so students, you must have seen that your parents or your grandparents must be preparing papad, pickles and jams. So when you observe all these kinds of the chaos happening around you, so when your mom or your grandparents prepare the papad, pickles and the jam at the home, Any guesses? What is the best time period to do all these things? Yeah, they prepare usually papads during the summer season. Am I right? Now, why we have to prepare papad only during the summer season? Why we cannot prepare papad during the winter season or rainy season? Let's consider, if we prepare papad during the rainy season or winter season, then what will happen? During rainy season, because of the rainwater, and during winter season, there will be a lot of moisture will be present inside the air. In the atmosphere will be full of moisture. And during rainy season and during winter season, we cannot dry papad well. Am I right? So for drying papad, what is required? Sunlight is required. So heat and the sunlight, it is only available in the maximum amount during the summer season. Am I right? So to dry papad very well, only during the summer season, we have to make the papad. Suppose if papads are not dried well, if the papads are moist only, and if we preserve them like that only in the container, then after 1 month, if you notice that, then on papad there will be growth of the fungus. You can see the cottony growth on the papad, and then that spoiled papad you cannot consume. It will become unfit to consume. And if this unfit food, if we consume, then we might suffer from the food poisoning. Did you understand that? So to prepare these papads are usually prepared during summer season, so that papads can be dried well under the sunlight. And during rainy season and winter season, there is no insurance of the sunlight. And that's why we usually make it during what? Summer season. And one more thing, why we make the pickles during the summer season? As you know that we eagerly wait for the summer just for the mangoes. Even the raw mangoes are available in the large quantities around us. So these large quantities of the raw mango, as they are available only during the summer season. Okay, we cannot store raw mango for winter season or for rainy season. Till winter season and till rainy season, these raw mangoes will get spoiled. So when they are available in the summer season, we make pickles, muramba from these raw mangoes. Okay, as mangoes are available in the large quantities only in the summer season, that's why we make the pickles also in the summer season. And have you observed, students, one more thing? While making pickles, we pour a lot of oil. And one more thing we do, we put a lot of salt also. Then why a lot of salt and oil is required? Because the reason is that the maximum salt and maximum oil which is present in the pickles, no, it avoids the fungal infection and it avoids the spoilage of the pickles. So to avoid the spoilage of the pickles, we add oil as well as the extra salt inside the pickles. And even one more thing you must have noticed, while making muramba and while making jams also, we add a lot of sugar. Even maximum concentration of sugar can avoid the spoilage of the food material. So that's why while making jams and while making muramba, we add extra quantity of the sugar so that the spoilage will be avoided. So you all know that right now I just told you that various kinds of the papad, jams, pickles, onion, fish and masalas are prepared and preserved for the whole year in many homes. And nowadays we can buy such ready products in the market too. But do we go daily to the market to buy the stuffs? No. Once in a month, we buy all the grocery, whatever we require for the month. Am I right? So, to avoid having to go to the market for provisions again and again, we store what we need for several days in our house. Am I right? So you must have also went for grocery shopping. So we buy everything in the larger quantity, whatever we require for whole month, so that the again and again market going will be avoided. So whatever grocery even we buy from the market, we preserve them in the dry condition. If we don't preserve them in the dry condition or in the refrigerator, the food will get spoiled. And that's why, student, the method for preservation, it is very important to learn. If we know the reasons why foodstuffs go bad, we would know what to do to keep them from spoiling. So there are certain techniques we should know to avoid the food spoilage. So what are those techniques which we should know? Let's learn that one by one here. Basically, you know that refrigeration of any kind of the food material, it is the best method. So in winter season, you must have noticed that foodstuffs remain fresh for longer time. While in the summer season, any kind of the food, it gets spoiled very immediately. So you can see that in the cold weather, foodstuffs keep longer. Even the temperature of the fridge is very low and it has a cold temperature, and that's why in the refrigerator they remain fresh. So if we keep any kind of the food in the refrigerator or kept on the cold ice, they even keep for the longer. Even if you have noticed that fish, it is also stored in the ice cubes. So when people preserve the fish on the ice cubes, the fish also remains fresh for many days also for consumption without getting spoiled. So what we learned, cold temperature is important to store the food material. And one more thing, as we learned that grains are dried in the sun before storing. Exactly in the same manner, when we buy onions and potatoes in the larger quantity, they are also kept in the dry open area so that we will stop their spoiling. If we store these potato and the onion in the moist area, then they will get damaged soon and they will also become unfit for consumption. So there are certain food material which has to be preserved in the dry condition. And what else we can do for preserving the food material? Boiling is one of the best way to avoid the spoilage of the food. You must have noticed that during summer season, we boil milk again and again. So when we boil milk again and again, what happens, you know, the microorganisms which are present inside the milk, they die because of the boiling process. Even if you have noticed that curries and vegetable which we make, that also we boil again and again before consuming. So boiling is the best way to avoid the spoilage of the food material. Did you understand now why the boiling is important? So students, till now what we learned? What are the ways of preserving the food material? So today we learned there are three ways of preserving the food material. What are they? Refrigeration, drying and boiling. So when we keep the food in the cold condition, it will remain fresh for longer time. And there are certain food material which has to be preserved in the dry condition. So even drying is the important technique to preserve the food material. And the most importantly, even boiling can also avoid the spoilage of the food material. Okay, so I hope so, student, you must have understood whatever concept we learned today. So the next part of this topic we will learn in the next session. So bye, take care.